Another thing, another representation is pie chart. Okay, it is a representation of the data in a circular form is known as pie chart. The each fraction is a whole of the whole form of the section is circles. It is as for information I am talking, it is not for studying. Look at here. Here is the data is represented in circular form. A potato 40 kilo. It is given the representing method is another one. Just you have to know. When we represent this data, some given data in a circular form, that is known as big pie chart. Okay, this first we have to given data should be converted into fractional form or degree means angles, form of angles. Using that we are protractor, that using the protractor that we are using it to draw this angles and these portions. That is the way of drawing this pie chart. There is no need to study now. We have just understand the here is another representation which is known as pie chart. That's all. Okay. Here, looking this picture, there are some questions is given. Here look at the potato. Total is 80 kilogram. 40 out of 80. That is make it a small fraction. This half. That is the half portion represents potato. And tomato 20 kilogram out of 8 is 20 by 80, that is 1 by 4. That is we are representing like 1 by 4 part. And beans is 10 out of 80 kilogram. Total is 80 kilogram of vegetables is we are talking about it, 10 by 8 is 1 by 8. 1 by 8 is represented over here. And 1 by 8 is carrot also. So it is represented here. We can draw it easily by when we convert this fractions into angle of degree, that is the representation of angles. Okay, using that we can easily draw it. Now no need to study about it. Look at this picture. Each part represents two color circle is divided into two. Each part represents half of the circle. Here the circle is divided into four, so each part represents 1/4. Here the each the circle is represented 3, so each part represents 1/3 of the circle. Just understand it. And one more show thing I have to show you. Look at here. Here is another work is given. This is also a bar graph, but this is represented in the form of a vertical graph. We have studied the graph as vertical graph. This is a horizontal graph. The bars are drawn as a horizontal way. That is, in the y-axis we are representing the things which are there representing, and the scale is we are using here marked on the x-axis, and this method of drawing is known as horizontal bars are using instead of vertical bars. This type method also we can use, but mostly we are using the vertical bar graphs are we are drawing and to represent the given data. Just for to here some questions are given, you can use going through the this data. After studying this chapter you can do the draw the bar graphs using this data. Okay, you can try it yourself. The next class we will study how to draw a bar graphs. Okay, thank you.